In this particular session, we are going to talk about suture material. So I have some sutures with me, which I will show you as samples so that it's easy for you to understand. So let's try to understand the suture material. So what are the different types of suture materials we have? We have natural absorbable, natural non-absorbable. Natural absorbable, we have catgut. And natural non-absorbable, we have silk. In catgut also, there are four different types of catgut. Okay, there is a plain catgut. There is a mild chromic, there is a medium chromic, there is extra chromic. So this chromic acid is specially added in the catgut for two specific reasons. One is to reduce its reaction and second is to make sure it stays in body for longer duration. Okay. So where is catgut made from? Catgut is made from the submucosa of sheep intestine, or alternatively it is made from the serosa layer of cattle intestine. Okay. And it is a natural absorbable suture material. What is the mechanism of action in which it gets dissolved? By enzymatic degradation. Okay, that is how it gets destroyed or it gets absorbed inside the body. And if you see the catguts, what are the different factors which affect the absorption of the catgut? Okay, so in presence of blood, pus, tension, infection, low protein status, catgut gets absorbed in the body even faster. So we want to make sure that, and catgut is one of the cheapest suture material, we need to remember that. Yes, there is some amount of reaction that it causes, okay, but then it gets absorbed inside the body and it just gives us adequate enough time which is needed for forming an adhesion at the level of blood supply whenever we are using it. Okay, so what happens in catgut? So now if you see, you try to understand what happens inside the body and how this affects the suture material. So at 7 days, 14 days, 21 days, 28 days, and around, maybe around 42 days, okay? So we will try to understand what happens. So the loss of tensile strength of catgut in 7 days of time is around 33%. In 28 days of time, we lose 66% of the tensile strength, and total absorption under ideal conditions for catgut is 60 days. Now it all depends. We are talking about medium chromic catgut over here. Okay, so this is about the catgut. So, and this is the catgut that we have. Now, there are three strands over here. And if you see, this catgut is size 1. It is 5 metrics. And there are three strands of 50.7 centimeters. And this should be size 1 size catgut should be suitable for you for operating dogs in a high volume ABC center. Maybe dogs about 10 kg, yes, you can possibly use them. For dogs which are less than 10 kg, size 20 or 4 metrics would be even better. So this is about your catgut. Then the next suture material that we have is called as synthetic absorbable suture materials. Okay, so we have Vicryl and PGA. These are two suture materials which are available to us. So in Vicryl also, there are three types of Vicryl, but we'll try to keep it simple first. We'll try to understand the Vicryl and PGA, which are very closely related suture materials. So, in Vicryl, in around 14 days of time, 35% of the tensile strength is lost. In around 21 days, around 60 to 65% of the tensile strength is lost. Total absorption for Vicryl is also 60 days. Now, Vicryl is polyglactin 910. Okay. Now, there are three types of Vicryl. There is Vicryl Rapid, Vicryl Normal and Vicryl Plus. Okay, so let's try to understand. I might have one Vicryl over here that I can possibly show you. So we have this as Vicryl Rapid. Okay, so this is the non-braided suture material and this is the rapid form of Vicryl. So in 1 week of time, more than 50% of the tensile strength is lost. 100% of the tensile strength is lost in 2 weeks of time. And total absorption under ideal conditions is 42 days. This gets absorbed inside the body very fast. It's only 42 days. Okay, so this is Vicryl Rapid. Non-braided, but it's a multifilament. It's a synthetic absorbable. And all synthetic absorbable get absorbed by hydrolysis mechanism. They're totally independent of the protein status of the patient. So, but it is a multifilament. Okay, so the knot security is better, but tissue drag, there's going to be some amount of tissue drag. And it's going to be a multifilament, so the knot security is definitely going to be better. Okay, so this is about your Vicryl. Then Vicryl Plus. So Vicryl Plus is a antibacterial Vicryl which is available to us as practitioners, medical practitioners. Okay, So in Vicryl Plus, only 25% of the tensile strength is lost in around 2 weeks of time, and only around 50 to 60% in 3 weeks of time. And total absorption time under ideal conditions can be anywhere between around 56 to 70 days. Okay, so this is about your Vicryl Plus. Now the other material that we usually need, which we usually use, is called as the PGA. Okay, so this is one PGA right now in front of me. It is 20 PGA. It comes with a reverse cutting needle. The length of the needle is around 4 centimeters, that's 40 millimeters. And the length of the suture material is around 90 centimeters. And this is almost 3.5. This is 3 metric, size 20. And important thing about PGA and Vicryl are quite similar. But in around 2 weeks of time, it loses around 35% of the tensile strength. In 3 weeks of time, Vicryl is actually 5% stronger. At 3 weeks, Vicryl is actually 5% stronger than PGA. And loss of tensile strength is around 60%. But total absorption time under ideal conditions for PGA is 90 days. Now, that's really important for us to understand, because the linea alba in case of a dog, no, the strength that it gains in around 2 months of time is only around 40%. So, we want a suture material which stays there for around 60 to 90 days. I would say 90 days. That's why it's better to use PGA than Vicryl when you're closing the linea alba, if you are using a multifilm. So that is an important thing for us to remember. Okay, so the knot security is going to be better, and it stays in body for around 90 days. We still have to maintain a sepsis, and it gets absorbed by hydrolysis, and it will hold the fascia, which is the primary holding layer. So this is about the PGA. There is another suture material which is a multifilament, okay, which is available to us, that is called as lactomer, braided lactomer it is called. So the loss of tensile strength in around 14 days is around 20% over here. Loss of tensile strength in around 2-3 weeks, it is around 70%. And total absorption time is also 60 days. So if you see, PGA is going to be much better in a low resource setting to close the midline in the multifilament option. Okay, that is about PGA. Now the strongest suture materials which are known to us is PDS and polyglyconate. So PDS is the strongest suture material which is known to us. In 14 days, only 14% of the tensile strength is lost. In 42 days, that is 6 weeks, only 31% of the tensile strength is lost. And total absorption time under ideal conditions is 180 days. That is 6 months. It's a monofilament, it doesn't cause reaction, it doesn't support bacteria, it doesn't support capillary, but it stays in body for like around 6 months. That is the strongest suture material which is known to us. That is PDS. Then there is another suture material which is quite similar to PDS, but still very slightly different, which is called as polyglyconate. So polyglyconate is in around 14 days of time, 30% of the tensile strength is lost. In around 3 weeks of time, 45% of the tensile strength is lost. And total absorption time under ideal conditions is 180 days. Please come. Join us, please. Okay, 180 days. So this is polyglyconate. This is also monofilament. This also doesn't support bacteria. This also doesn't support capillary. It is inert inside, but it is weaker as compared to PDS, but stronger as compared to other suture materials that we. Then there is another suture material. So this is about long-acting monofilaments. Okay. So now let's come to a category which is called as intermediate acting suture materials. There are three drugs over here. There are three agents over here. One is polyglycaprone 25. Okay, it is called as monocryl. So this is one of the suture materials, monocryl. Then there is called as a glycomer 631, biocin it is called. And then there is called as caprosin, polyglyton 6211. So how are these suture materials different? So let's try to understand one by one. Let's talk about monocryl. So monocryl is one suture material which is non-braided, it is monofilament, it doesn't support capillary, it doesn't support bacteria, it will not cause reaction. But in 50% of the tensile strength of monocryl is lost in around weeks time. 70 to 80% of it is lost in around 2 weeks of time. But total absorption under ideal condition is 110 to 120 days, 90 to 120 days. So it is staying inside the body much longer than the PGA, 120 days. Okay, it is not braided. It is a monofilament. And this material would be of use in a cat. Because the cat wound healing is twice as slow as dog wound healing at 2 months of age. If the fascia of a dog is regaining around 40% of the strength, you can be sure that the fascia of a cat is going to regain not equivalent, it's going to be less. So 90 days of suture material ideally is not suitable for a cat midline because it needs a suture which stays longer over there because the wound healing is slow as compared to a dog.
Here's some results from a search.
Okay, so this is an important thing. So cats have, they react with cat guts, so we should not be using cat guts in a cat. And for BJ also they are developing reactions. They are very sensitive. They got fat necrosis and they react with the PGA. So when we had started having a lot of problems with the suture materials, we tried to work on it case by case. And when I started using the monocryl, with discussions with some of our overseas vet experts as well. So they suggested that they start using monofilament. So we have a benefit of a monofilament. We have a benefit of a non-braided suture material. But let me tell you, there is a drawback over here. We lose 50% of the strength in a week's time. And we are losing 70% in 2 weeks of time. So, technically, this has reduced the problem of reactions. It has reduced the problem of infections. Okay? But, in my personal opinion, we need a suture material which stays in body for 110 to 120 days, but which is superior to this. That is Biosyn. Or Glycomer 631. So why do I say that? Let me explain. So Glycomer 631 is a suture material which loses around 25% of its tensile strength in around 2 weeks of time. Around 50 to 60% of its tensile strength in around 3 weeks of time. But total absorption is 110 days. So, but the problem is it has some dye. It is a monofilament. It doesn't support bacteria. Knot security of all the monofilaments is going to be a little bit poor as compared to the multifilaments. It will not support bacteria, it will not support capillary, but it does have a dye in it. Okay? But it also stays for long. So there is nothing called as an ideal suture material. But I feel that I have not got enough time and resources right now to use Biosyn because the companies couldn't give it and I don't have enough number of cash to do it. But in future I am going to do it to see if Biosyn will offer better wound healing in a cat. Now, it is not practical for us to start using PDS in all the cats because first thing is it is expensive and second thing is it stays in body for more than 6 months and we don't want a suture material even if it is inert to stay in a body for more than the recommended time. Okay, so we talked about Biosyn. Okay, another suture material that we are talking about is called as Caprosyn. Caprosyn is nothing but polyglytone 6211. Okay, so this suture material loses 50% of its tensile strength within a week's time. It loses almost 80 to 90% of its tensile strength in 10 days of time. And total absorption time is only 56 days in ideal conditions. So technically it is a monofilament. It doesn't support capillary action. It doesn't support bacteria. It's not having a dye also. But it is getting so absorbed so fast inside the body that we cannot use it for a midline. Because midline, linea alba has poor blood supply. Okay, so depending upon where you're using your suture material, which is the tissue, okay, and how much time is needed for wound healing and how much time is needed for the suture to get breakdown in the body. Now those are important things. So the pattern, the material and the place where we are using it, that really makes a huge difference and that's the secret of the success. Okay, so let me make these things even easier for you. So we talk about cat guts, natural absorbable. Then we talk about Vicryl, three types of Vicryl. Now let me make it easy for you. So Vicryl Rapid and Monocryl, Polyglycaprolin 25, are quite similar. The only difference is Vicryl is a multifilament, this is a monofilament. But the way they dissolve inside the body in terms of time interval, in the loss of tensile strength, is quite similar. So the absorption time of Vicryl Rapid and absorption time of Monocryl is quite different. This is 42 days and this is like 120 days. So that's the difference. But if you want to recall these information, no? Vicryl Rapid and Monocryl are quite similar. The only thing is this is the multifilament, this is the monofilament. Same thing is, Vicryl Plus and Glycomer 631 are quite similar suture materials in terms of loss of tensile strength in 14 days and 21 days. But this is a multifilament, this is a monofilament. Are you able to understand? Okay, so this is the way I find it very easy to remember these things. So these are our synthetic absorbable suture materials. So starting from catgut, four types of catgut, then Vicryl, three types of Vicryl, Vicryl Rapid, Vicryl Normal, Vicryl Plus, then we have PGA, then we have Monocryl, that is Polyglycapron 25, then we have Biosane, which is Glycomer 631, then we have Caprosane, which is Polyglyton 6211, then we have Polyglyconate, then we have PDS, and that's all. We don't have any synthetic absorbable suture materials, at least not in the standard literature. Okay? But the non-absorbable suture materials, we have 5 polys. So why do I call 5 polys? Because that's the easiest way to remember them. Polypropylene, polyamide, polyester, polybutester, polymerized caprolactam, and stainless steel. That's it. So polypropylene and polyamide are both synthetic non-absorbable. They could be monofilament, they could be monofilaments are available very easily. Proline is much better, but it comes at a price. Polyamide is much cheaper, still a monofilament. I would suggest, yes, we can go for it. Now, polybutester is the only one which is a monofilament. Polyester is a multifilament. Supramid, you can call it. That's a multifilament. Stainless steel is a monofilament. Now, nowadays we don't use stainless steel, but it was used extensively earlier. So, these are all the suture materials known to us. And there are no suture materials beyond this. So that means that though technically I have taken a lot of names, they are still less considering we have so many different areas where we tend to use sutures. So the choice of the suture material, the pattern, the place where we use and the type of sutures that we use and the tension that we place, how long do we want it in the body and how long the body wants to heal. Now this is the race that we need to try to balance. And if you are able to understand this, then you are going to be able to make best use of your suture material. Okay, thank you so much for this.